We are starting a new series today called Diving Into the Bible, where we're going to learn why we read the Bible. What is there to learn about? Where do we read it? When do we read it? How do we read it? There's so much that we can learn, and I really am hoping that by the end of this term, you will have fallen in love with your Bible. Now, we're going to have a friend come along to teach us some interesting facts about the Bible. And I really want you to pay attention because we're going to be running some competitions throughout the term to see if you are listening. So listen up. But here he is, my friend Joe. Joe, welcome to Roll Kids. How are you?
I'm well, thanks, Helen. And you?
I'm brilliant. It's so wonderful to have you with us. So Joe, can you tell me and tell the kids a little bit about yourself?
Well, my name is Joe Bloggs, and I have a daughter called Jane Bloggs and a son called Little Joe Bloggs. We come from Chiretsi and we love the bush and going camping and fishing and all that sort of stuff. And I love kids.
Awesome. Well, we are so chuffed to have you here with us. Now, Joe, I noticed that you were one of the very first people to sign up on Church Suite. That's amazing. Well done. Do you know what? There's some people in the church who still haven't signed up. And I figure if you can do it, anybody can do it. Am I right?
Yes, it's very easy. Children, get your parents to sign up on Church Suite so that we know when your birthdays are and can get you some sweets for when we meet together.
Yeah, absolutely. So Joe, you're here to help us learn some interesting Bible facts.
That's correct, Helen.
So tell me, my Bible looks like one big fat book. Is that correct?
No, not at all. It is one book, but it's made out of 66 different books.
Oh, wow. Okay. So is that our first fact, Joe?
Yes. Our first fact is the Bible is made up of 66 books.
Okay, brilliant. So tell me, Joe, did one person write all of those 66 smaller books?
No, Helen. The Bible is written by 30 authors over hundreds of years.
Okay, amazing.
They also were inspired by God's Holy Spirit.
Okay, so that must be our second fact. The Bible is made up of 66 books written by 30 different people over hundreds of years. But I think you said something else. What else did you say, Joe?
That they were all inspired by the Spirit of God.
Okay, amazing. Children, I hope you are listening to Joe. He's teaching us some awesome stuff. Thank you, Joe. We'll see you next week. God bless.
Cheers, Helen.
Right, let's get across and see what we've got for our lesson today. Wow, kids, don't you just love Joe? And I'm so excited that he is going to be joining us every week in Roll Kids and teaching us some amazing Bible facts. So let's get into our new series called Diving Deep. And I don't know if any of you have been to the sea and whether, like me, you've walked along the beach and searched for hours for pretty shells and little things that you can find on the beach. I just love this starfish. It's absolutely amazing. And this beautiful shell that I picked up one day when I was at the seaside. And these are clues that there are tiny little creatures living far beneath the ocean that we can't see when we just look at the sea. You know, if all we ever do when we go to the seaside is take a beach ball and throw that around, or we grab our bucket and spade and we build sandcastles, it might be lots of fun, and it really is, but it's not going to help us to discover these amazing things that are far beneath the ocean. And the Bible is a lot like that. The Bible is full of wisdom and knowledge that if we read it, completely will transform our lives. But if we just do a little bit of reading here and a little bit of reading there, and we don't read our Bible for weeks and then we get back to it, we will never discover the mysteries and the truths of what God wants us to learn. The Bible is called the living words of God. It's His instruction manual for us. He created us. He made each of us to do something special. And in the Bible, He will reveal it to us. And so that's what we're going to learn about in this series. Why should we read the Bible? How should we read the Bible? But there's so much to learn. Every story can teach us something. Every person that's mentioned, whether they love God or not, God will use them to teach us things. And so I really want to encourage you to understand that the Bible isn't some boring big book with lots of words. It's a love story about a God who is loving and powerful and kind, and how He gave up His most precious thing for every person in the world. It's a history book that tells of the story of the nation of Israel and how God tried and tried to bring them into a great relationship with Him. It's got poetry. It's got the Psalms, which teach us how to praise God. It's got the Proverbs, which are practical books of wisdom that teach us things from how to save money to how to avoid sin and live godly lives. The letters that Paul wrote, and you're going to look at one of them in a little bit, to Timothy, teaches us how to live like Jesus lived. And as we get through, you'll see there's Revelations, which reveals to us a little glimpse of what it's going to be like to live in eternity forever with God. So guys, I really want to encourage you to learn to love this book with all your heart. It is an amazing book. To spend time to look at how you can understand it. God wants us to question, why was that person in the Bible? What did that mean? Why did they go there? Think through these things and ask your parents, ask your friends. God wants us to ask questions. He wants us to talk to Him and say, please, Holy Spirit, reveal what this means. And He wants us to really have a love for His word. So that's what we're learning about this whole term. And I really encourage you to pick up your Bible in the morning. You don't have to spend hours. You don't have to read pages and pages. But take a little part and ask God, as you spend time with Him, what He wants to teach you for today. So kids, you're going to go now with any other children that are with you in your group. Maybe it's just your brothers or sisters. Maybe there's friends there. And go off with someone a bit older, and we've planned some activities for you. There's going to be some games, there's some craft, there's some more discussion, time to pray. So have a really great Sunday. I hope you enjoy it. God bless. Okay, kids, so remember, get rid of your floaties, get rid of your armbands, and dive into your Bibles. You will never regret it.